two families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 Rand. In rounds 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 Rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Well, welcome to Family Feud, South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. All right, so this is the way this works. Our researchers have been out on the streets of Mzansi. Yes. Asking you for some answers to some really simple questions. But when you get up here under the lights, they're not so simple. But all you gotta do is match up the answers to those questions that's locked into this game board up here. A lot of people up here can walk away with some serious money for the charity of their choice. And, well, today, folks, in this special edition, we got two really special families with us today from two of your favorite radio stations right here. Give it up for the team from YFM. They're battling it out against KFM. Everybody's here trying to win themselves some cash, and one of these teams will be out here playing for the big jackpot of 75,000 Rand for their favorite charity.
Yes.
So let's get it on. Give me Kutso, give me Carl. Hello, Kutso. Did I say it right? Kutso, Carl.
Yes.
What's up, brother?
Hi.
How y'all doing?
We good, thank you.
Good. Look wonderful. Mm. One hand on the desk, the other behind your back. I noticed you all didn't shake hands. We have a problem.
All right, let's do it.
Shake hands?
Let's shake hands.
Hi.
Are you guys morning drive, afternoon drive?
So we all different, morning,
midday,
mixture.
Oh, we've got the stars of the station.
We've got the stars of the station.
Same for you, Carl?
We've got a nice blend. We've got afternoon drive show in Cape Town, as well as one very, very talented 9 to 12 DJ in the middle.
I'm assuming that might be you, Carl.
Actually, thank you, but it is the lovely lady in red behind me.
Well, ladies, I don't want to start anything, but I'm in television, and by the looks of you ladies, you all should be in television, too. Y'all need to be on TV.
Be
with your money right. I got an idea right now. Hey, let's play the game, y'all. We surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers are on the board. We ask 100 men, name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
Lingerie.
Lingerie.
Yeah, baby.
Lingerie. Pass or play?
Are we playing? We play, Steve.
We play.
Let's do this.
Kutsu, so what day part?
So I do the 9 to 12 mid-morning brunch leading into afternoon.
9 to 12
That's
mid-morning
the one.
Brunch. I just got here, I'm learning.
Can I teach you something?
Yes.
Just say loko va vutisa.
Loko va vutisa.
Kuri ufamba na mani.
Loko va vutisa.
I love it. Yes.
Loko va vutisa.
Yes.
You got what?
What?
Give me another one.
All right. Obajele.
Obajele.
Kuro ufamba na.
Kuro ufamba na.
YFM.
YFM. wonderful to have you. Introduce everybody.
All right, so on my left,
yeah.
DJ Ankle Tap does our breakfast 5 a.m. to 9 a.m.
Yep.
The one and only DJ Ankle Tap. Malume Pompo. Next to him is his co-host, Candace Kardashian. You want us to stop for a minute?
Wait a minute, for real? For real, no.
For real. This is Candace Kardashian.
Yes, okay. Sir.
All right. Next to Candace Kardashian, we've got Sapta.
Sapta. Woo! Hey. My man.
The A-class DJ.
Yep.
And last but not least, we've got Tepi, also on Drive Woo! Time, on YFM.
All right, Kutso, what charity are you guys playing for?
We are a youth radio station, so it only makes sense to go for a children's charity called Children's Flight.
Beautiful. All right, good. All right, let's go. DJ Ankle Tap.
Yes, Uncle Steve.
The name. Explain the name.
So you see, you know, it's a long story, but basically at school I didn't have ankles and there's a sport, Steve. Do you know a sport named rugby?
Let's stop. In school you didn't have ankles.
Well, that was the rumor that went around. So you see, I was born with club feet, yeah? And I used to have crutches at school, so it was like a negative nickname that I turned into a positive name, but that was basically You see, Steve, there's a sport here called rugby, and we're the world champions in rugby. But in rugby, an ankle tap is
where... You're referring to the Springboks.
Yeah, the Springboks, right? Yeah. Right, correct. Steve knows his stuff. So, yeah, an ankle tap is when you hit someone on the ankle while they're running past, and they hit the floor.
Wow. All right, man. I'm learning. Let's go. We ask 100 men, name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
Thong.
Come on, boy.
Come on. Yes, sir.
Come on.
Yes, sir. Yes. Come. Yes.
You naughty.
Thong. That was a great answer.
Hey, son, I'm pleased, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, Candace Kardashian.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And what's amazing, I know all of your sisters.
Right?
So you're Candace Kardashian. 100%. Wow. Do they know you're over here? We ask 100 men, name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
I would say high heels.
Yes. Yes. High heels.
Oh, no! Oh, no! What?
What men did they ask? Sapta.
Sapta.
My man. You got swag, Sapta. I gotta give it to you. You guys swear you're cool. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm looking at you, dog. Something. You dripping with it. It's just dripping. It's on you. You dripping with it, man. That's what we say, you know, you dripping. It's dripping. To drip, it's just on you. I can't help it. Look at me. What day part you work, man?
Oh, I do weekends.
Weekend.
Fridays and Saturdays. I'm the plug. I'm the A-class DJ.
What time is that?
6 to 10.
Oh, you got it cranked up.
I've got it cranked up.
He's a party starter. Stop.
6 to 10 on the weekend.
Yep.
Well, that's good, brother. Let's play the game. Talk to 100 men. Name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
Lace dress.
Lace dress. A lace dress.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Well done, my guy. Well done.
Go on.
TCP. TCP.
Woo!
TCP.
Tippy.
Girl, you better get away from me.
Don't look at my eyes too long.
Yeah, I'm not.
You're gonna get lost in these eyes.
Yeah, no, my son will, but I can't. I can't get lost in nobody's eyes but Marjorie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I'm trying to go to heaven.
Sure.
So what day part you work?
I do 3 to 7 on the best drive. I'm going to co-host, yeah.
That's pretty good. Okay, I have a question.
Cool.
What is the number one song for young people today? What's the major
Lot. Everybody loch, who pass a gum nut. Everybody loch, who trap a gum nut. Everybody loch,
nuts, nuts.
That's number one song. It's a genre called.
Let me guess the genre of music.
Okay.
A rapper piano.
I'm a piano.
No idea what I just did. All right, darling. 100 men, name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
Well, I know that men are weak for legs, right?
Yes, yes.
Mini skirt.
God, yes. A mini skirt.
A mini skirt, yes.
Correct.
Wonderful.
Yes.
We ask 100 men name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
I am a diehard fan of leggings.
Yes.
So I'm gonna go with leggings.
Leggings! Yes! Ankle tap. We got 2 strikes. You gotta be careful. KFM from Cape Town can steal. 100 men name an item of clothing that looks sexy on a woman.
Body suits.
Body suits. Body suits. All right, team, here we go. We talked to 100 men. Name an item of clothing. Look sexy on a woman.
Denim shorts.
Denim shorts. Look at the remaining answers. Number 7. Jeans. Number 4.
Jeans.
Well, we're playing Family Feud celebrity style here. YFM, not on the board yet. KFM 72. Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud. We got 2 good teams, man. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. YFM not on the board. KFM got 72. Yes. Give me DJ Ankle Tap. Yes. Give me Zoe. Tap, 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 tap. Yes. We surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name a common South African slang term for hello.
Fede.
What?
Fede.
Fede. Fede. Fede.
How's it?
Huh?
How's it?
How's it? Pass or play?
We're gonna play. We're gonna play. Yes.
All right, let's go. Well, we're over here, so Carl, What charity are you playing for?
We are playing for the Red Cross Children's Hospital. They do some very, very great work in the community. They look after the kids, and more importantly, they are the voice of many of the kids going to the hospital by creating their own radio station called RX Radio. So as radio presenters, we want to make sure that the kids are inspired in the hospital with kids who are actually entertaining them on their radio station, which
is
beautiful.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. That's pretty cool. All right, now, I'm gonna let you introduce everybody.
All right, so on my right over here, we have Zoe, and she does traffic on my show called The Flash Drive on KFM 94.5. Tracy, the one I was talking about in red, 9 to 12, a very, very important slot in radio, and she does it with such prowess and class, just to let you know. And then there's somebody, I know his name might be difficult to pronounce. If you look at his name, how would you say that?
Petrus.
Hmm. Petrus.
What?
Yeah. Petrus.
You need another letter. You're gonna need some more letters.
Petrus.
Petrus, you're gonna need another letter.
The last one. You wanna give it a shot?
Kato.
Almost?
Almost, almost. Mm.
It's like when you go around Cape Town, you go for a tour. So it's ka-tour.
Ka-tour.
Yes.
That was actually
That's
amazing.
Well done.
That's it, well done. 5 points. 5 points.
You do you, Steve, if you want to...
You all are
you want
missing
a Kato
letters.
Or Katua? Yeah.
Katua needs another letter. So, Tracy, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How
good,
are you?
Good, good, wonderful, wonderful. You ready to play?
Yes, I am.
Okay, good. Name a common South African slang term for hello.
Awe.
Awe. Awe. Awe! Yeah! Pietras, what's the big news story right now?
No idea.
Springboks.
I've been focusing on Family Feud prepping, you know, making sure that
oh, that's all
our team win. Yeah. Yes.
You've been working
I've
on
I've been
it.
Watching you for the last 2 weeks.
My man.
Really?
Nice.
There you go.
Huge story. All right, man, let's go. Name a common South African slang term for hello.
What's up?
What's up? Huh? What's up? What's up?
What's up?
What's up?
What's up?
That ain't South African.
Yeah.
Everybody do that. All black people I know do that. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up?
Oh, well, that one.
All right, only
one. It's only one. It's only one. It's only one. It's only one.
Yes. Good. Name a common South African slang term. South African. What's up? That's not South African. For hello.
Molo.
See? Now, you know how I know that's South African? Because I don't know what that is. Molo! Yeah! All right, Carl, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful. YL Film, they look like they would steal.
Yes.
Name a common South African slang term for hello.
Shop.
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 Let's go.
Let's do this, guys.
Let's go. Okay, now how do you say hurry up and come over here?
To who?
To me.
To you. Nkomla wa kisa utala.
Ekamla kisa wala tala. I come like Kisa Walatala.
Wow.
I don't know why, but when you talk to me, I can actually repeat everything you say.
Almost, not to the T, but you did.
I'm not going to get it to the T, not today.
I'm proud of you, not today.
Because I'm just now learning,
Tsonga.
Huh?
I'm teaching you Tsonga.
Yeah, that's what I'm...
All right.
Name a common South African slang term for hello.
Hola.
Hola. Hola. Number six. Five.
Yes!
Four.
Hey!
That ain't African. Hey! Just... Number one. Well, that's round two, everybody. We got a game now. YFM is on the board, 18. KFM got 72. Don't go away. After the break, the family's gonna be playing for double the points. We got two good teams. We're having fun. Let's go. Back to Family Feud, everybody. Well, folks, everybody's on the board, so let's see. YFM got 18, KFM got 72. Give me Candace, give me Tracy. This is gonna be so good. Ladies, welcome to the show. Point values are double. Surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Finish their homework.
Finish their homework. One answer.
Teacher's pet.
Teacher's pet. Pass or play?
We're gonna play. We're playing, we're playing, we're playing, we're playing. Yes, thank you.
Beatrice, name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Cleans the classroom.
Cleans. Wow. Cleans.
I used to do that. I was the goody two-shoes.
You cleaned the classroom?
Wipe the boards.
For what?
Brownie points.
Brownie points?
Didn't improve my marks, but, you know, the teachers liked me.
My marks were so low, there was nothing I could do. Teacher, can I clean up the room? Yeah, you can do it, but you're still gonna fail. Clean up the classroom? Katua. Katua.
Welcome to my space.
Yes. Yeah. Lovely space it is, Katua. Wonderful having you here. Only one strike?
Yes.
Name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Buys the teacher presents.
Wow. Buys the teacher presents. Buys the teacher presents.
What school is this?
Paul, we need this. We got two strikes, partner.
I got you.
YFM can steal.
Mm-hmm.
Name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Listens in class.
Listens in class. Two strikes, Zoe. Is it Zoe or Zoe?
Zoe.
Just Zoe. Zoe, two strikes. We got to be careful. YFM can steal. Name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Sit in the front.
Sit in the front. Sit in the front.
Oh, no! Oh, my God.
We have some good answers left. Name something a goody two-shoes does at school.
Good marks. Straight A's.
Good marks. Straight A's. Number six. Three. Number one. KFM has taken the lead, 76. KFM still hanging strong, 72. Don't go away. After the break, we're playing for double the points. Really good. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game now. YFM got 76. KFM got 72. Give me Septa. Give me Beatrice. Mm. All right, fellas. Point values are double. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-laws to do.
Give them money.
Give them money.
Give them grandkids.
Give them grandkids.
We're gonna play.
Yeah, play.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Katua, name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-laws to do.
Cook.
To you better be able to cook. Cook. Carl, name something in-laws. Are you married, Carl?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, name something your in-laws expect their daughter-in-law to do.
Clean.
Clean. You must clean. Clean. Zoe?
Yes.
Name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-law to do.
Be polite.
Be polite. Only one strike, Tracy.
Yes.
Name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-laws to do.
Be a good wife.
Be a good wife.
Yes!
Be perfect, beautiful. Are you married?
No, I'm not.
Not. Beatrice, my man, only one strike. Name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-law to do.
Drive them around.
What?
Drive them around.
What? Drive me around? That's like driving Miss Daisy.
Yes.
Drive her around. Katua, the other station can steal. Something in-laws expect their daughter-in-law to do.
Listen to their
Listen.
Husband.
Listen, Linda. Linda, listen. Listen, Linda. Listen, Linda, listen. That was a good one. That was a good one. One answer left. Clear the board. Take the lead. Carl.
Yeah.
The captain.
Yeah.
The fearless leader.
Mm-hmm.
One answer left, two strikes,
all
right. Or YFM can try to pull it out. Name something in-laws expect a daughter-in-law to do.
To be well-kept or look good.
To be well-kept. Get yourself together. Could have gotten someone else. Pull yourself together, girl. This is a tough one. It's only one left. They're discussing it. Wonderfully hanging in there. Name something in-laws expect their daughter-in-law to do.
Legaya.
Yes.
Has to be respectful. Respectful. Number one, respectful, Faith. Yes. Respect.
Respectful. Number four.
Look after his son.
All right, folks, here's the situation. Whoever has the most points at the end of this round goes on to play Fast Money, has a chance of winning the jackpot of 75,000 Rand for their favorite channel. Let's get it on. Give me her. Give me her. We down to this here now. Oh, we done got a little attitude.
It's all love. Love.
Yes.
Cease.
Love.
All right, ladies. Point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people. We got top 5 answers on the board. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
Bewitch the princess.
Bewitch the princess. I guess if you have... I just wanted to see what they... Is that African or that's just...
No.
Just two women doing some stuff. This is for the game, guys. But you have to hang in there because you could steal and win it. So you never know. Let's play Feud. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
Fly on a broomstick.
Fly on a broomstick.
Yes! Massive, guys.
DJ Ankle Tap. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
Make a potion.
Make a potion. Yes! Candace Kardashian.
Yes, Steve.
Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
Have a sidekick.
Have a sidekick. Supta. Only one strike. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
It will have a weird animal.
What?
Yep, like a vulture, a raven, or an owl.
A weird animal.
It's for effect.
It's for effect.
It's for effect.
For the weird animal. Two strikes. If it's there, you're still playing. If it's not there, KFM can steal and win the game. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
Oh, snip! So you see, I'm thinking... After casting a spell on the princess, she would be so wicked.
Yeah.
And want to marry the prince.
What? Okay. Then took the side chick and stole a man and tried to marry him. KFM, I want you to listen to this. There's two answers on the board. If either answer is there, KFM wins the game. But if it's not there, you don't steal it and get the money, YFM wins the game. You must steal to win, or they get the points. It's tight here. The tension is building. The room, palms are sweating. Somebody's playing for 75,000 rand for their favorite charity. Name something a wicked witch in a fairy tale would do.
I believe evil laugh or cackle.
Evil laugh or cackle.
I want you.
The evil laugh or cackle for the win. I would have never guessed that. Number five. Well, home team. God, y'all. Anyway, I know you're heartbroken, but you really played well. You played well, you showed up. You still made some fantastic money for your favorite charity, and you're taking away 3,800 rand. KFC is generously donating another 10,000 rand to your charity. So that's a grand total of 13,800 rand, everybody. All right, I need two of you to play Fast Money. I got Pearson, I got Carl. We'll be right back. Favorite charity, let's go. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. Well, Station KFM won the game. Yes. And now it's time to play. Fast Money. All right, this is how Fast Money works, Carl. Beatrice is off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. You try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. I'll get back to it if we have enough time. Mm-hmm. If you and Beatrice together come up with 200 points, tell everybody what you're gonna win for your favorite charity.
75,000 rand!
That's all I need. I just need a little bit of hair right here. If I could just get me some hair right here. Just. All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please.
Let's do it.
Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something parents tell their children not to waste.
Water.
A body part you can stretch.
Leg.
Seafood people order at a restaurant.
Calamari.
A word that starts with hyper.
Hyperventilate.
Something that smells bad.
Feet.
All right, let's go, Carl. Let's see what we got, buddy. All right, here we go. Name something parents tell their children not to waste, and you said? Water. Survey said? A body part you can stretch. You said? Legs. Survey said? Seafood people order at a restaurant. You said?
Calamari.
I love calamari. Survey said? Whoa. A word that starts with hyper, you said?
Hyperventilate.
Hyperventilate, what I do when I get in ocean water. Survey said?
Oh.
What? All right, let's go. Something that smells bad, you said?
Feet.
Feet, survey said? All right, let's go. We'll be all right. We got parties. All right, let's bring out Beatrice. All right, Beatrice, how long have you known Carl?
I've worked with him, I think, for the last 4 or 5 years almost now.
Yeah, pretty cool guy.
Yeah.
I like him. I like him a lot. Let me ask you a question. How many points you think Carl got?
120.
Because he loves me.
Is he leaving everything to me now, basically?
Yeah, yeah, basically.
He already owes me a lot, so...
He gave a couple of really good answers. He just really did. Just notice about this game. You can give a great answer and it not be up there. You can do it. Because we asked 100 people. And there are obviously some special people, so... Carl got 58, you need 142.
No pressure.
I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'll say try again. You give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time. We're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Okay.
All right, let's remind everybody of Carl's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. All right, let's go. Name something parents tell their children not to waste.
Food.
A body part you can stretch.
Penis.
Seafood people order at a restaurant.
Calamari.
Try again.
Sushi.
A word that starts with hyper.
Hyperactive.
Something that smells bad.
A thought.
Yeah.
Come on, Drifters! Why would you...
Wow. This who y'all thought was gonna win the money for you? You ready? All right, let's go. Let's turn around and see what we got. You need 142 points for the win. Let's see. Name something parents tell their children not to waste. You said food. Survey said, boom, that's a big one. That's a big one. That's a big one. Food was the number one answer. You are now 100 points away. It could happen. A body part that you can stretch. You said your penis. How old are you?
I was thinking back to
how old are you?
38.
38. You can still stretch it? I'm gonna tell you right now, you stop stretching it around 10.
I was thinking in the younger days.
Yeah, well, survey said, That's a doggone shame. All right, we need 94 points. Seafood people order at a restaurant. You said sushi. Survey said. Fish was the number one answer. We're 81 points away. A word that starts with hyper. You said hyperactive. Survey said, boom. That's another big one. Hyperactive was number one. 47 points away. Oh man, something that smells bad. You said a fart. Survey said, ooh. Poop. Poop was number one.
Come on, give it to me.
Wow. Well, but hey, folks, we're gonna triple your dollars so you walk out with a grand total, 48,100 Rand for your favorite charity. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, everybody.
Yeah.
you had a nice time.
Thanks, Mr. Steven. It was great.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Hope you had a good time,
it
brother.
It was great. Thank you so much.
I enjoyed y'all. Hope you had a good time.